guys, what is up? So good to see you. Welcome to Habits. If you're joining for the first time, my name is Kylie. I'm the student pastor here at Blue Oaks, and we have, for the last couple of weeks, been going through this series talking about what it looks like for us to build habits or rhythms to grow our relationship with God. We've been talking about what habits are, how we can listen to God, how we can talk to God in prayer. Today we're going to be looking at a habit that is probably a big challenge for us. It's a challenge for me, probably a challenge for you, and that is the habit of talking about God with others. Last week we talked about talking with God in terms of prayer, important habit. Today we're going to be talking about what it looks like for us to talk about God with others and how that is a habit we can build into our lives. We like to kick things off with a prayer, so let's pray. Lord, we thank you that you love us, Lord, that you are with us all the time, that you are a God who knows us, and that you're a God who wants a relationship with us. And Lord, as we talk specifically about this habit, I ask that you would just challenge us. Lord, this can be a big one for a lot of us. And so just give us confidence, make us feel secure, Lord, and allow us to have moments where we can talk about you to others this week. We love you, and we thank you for today. In your name we pray, amen. What is something you guys love to talk about? I know some of the middle school girls love to talk about Grey's Anatomy. We talk about it all the time. Guys, I know you guys love to talk about, I'm old so I don't know, but like Fortnite and Roblox and whatever you're doing with your online games. You guys know that right now Formula One season is on, so I love talking to you about my favorite Formula One drivers, right? We all have things that we love to talk about. We love to talk about things we're passionate about and things that we love to do and love to see, and those are fun. Those things that we talk about help build connections with friends and family. But do we talk about God as much as we talk about the other things in our lives? I know for myself, the answer is probably no, right? I talk about God a lot at work because I'm a pastor, and I talk a lot about God with you guys, and I talk about God a lot with the staff. But sometimes when I leave church, when I go and hang out with friends, or when I go into the city, sometimes my talk is less about God and more about the other things. And we're going to be talking about what it looks like for us to build a habit of talking to others about God. Here's what we're not going to be saying in today. Right? We're not going to be saying that you can only talk about God 24/7. That's not true. God doesn't want that from us. Oh, we're not going to be saying that all you can talk about is God, or that if you don't talk about God all the time, you're a bad Christian. None of that is true. But I found in my life that at times God opens up opportunities to talk about God to others. And how when we start building that habit, even though it's an awkward habit, how God will open up conversations where we get to talk about him. And as we talk more and more about God and who God is in our lives, we get to grow deeper in our relationship with God. Talking to God and talking about God to others helps us know God better. And it helps build this habit of relationship connection. We're going to be looking at a verse in Acts. Now, Acts is in the New Testament, and it comes right after the Gospels. So the New Testament starts with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Those are the stories about Jesus, and Acts follows that. And people often say that Acts was written by somebody who wrote some of the New Testament as well, so there's some continuity, some strands connecting the two. Acts are stories about the early church, about what was happening at the beginning of the movement after Jesus had gone back up to heaven. And in Acts, we see people using their day-to-day lives to talk about God to others. And we see the transformation that that brings. We're gonna be looking at Acts 4, verses 13. In Acts 4, we see two disciples of Jesus, two guys that were with Jesus, that knew about Jesus, that were connected to Jesus, Peter and John. And we get to see how them talking about God in their day-to-day lives helps other people experience God. Here is what Acts says. It says, when they saw the courage of Peter and John and realized that they were unschooled, ordinary men, they were astonished and they took note of that these men had been with Jesus. So what is happening in this section of Acts? Well, Peter and John, who were two people who were in a relationship with Jesus, loved Jesus, were connected with him. They were starting the church, the early church. They didn't have buildings. They didn't have small groups. They were just in this small, like, hangout time. And Peter and John, because they experienced Jesus, told people about it. They told people about how they saw Jesus heal others. They told people about how they heard Jesus speaking. They told people about how Jesus prayed with them, about how Jesus changed their lives. And the people who heard these stories were changed. I love a few things about this specific verse in Acts. I love that it talks about how Peter and John were unschooled, ordinary men. It makes me laugh because it's kind of like, a bit of a hate shade on Peter and John, right? Peter and John were telling stories, and then people realized, like, oh, these guys have never been to school. These guys haven't been trained. These guys have nothing other than their experience. But when they shared this experience, things happened. The people took note, and they got to know who Jesus was because of the stories that Peter and John were sharing. Here are some really cool things that I get from this story, right? The first is that our experience with Jesus shapes who we are. Our experience, our relationship with God should change and be part of who we are and our identity, right? My love of Jesus should fuel my love for others. My grace that I know I have from God should help me when I want to say something that's mean. Peter and John had their lives shaped by their experience with God. And friends, we should be thinking about the way our experience with God shapes our lives. And once we know that, once we experience that, then we should be open to telling others. Peter and John were so transformed by God, so transformed by this experience with Jesus, that they naturally wanted other people to experience that. They wanted people to experience that love. They wanted other people to experience that grace. They wanted other people to experience that peace. And guess what? They were unschooled and ordinary. They didn't need to have super fancy language. They didn't need to have a full script. They didn't need any of that. All they needed was what they had with Jesus, their experience. And the same thing happens in our lives, right? We talk a lot about how God has created each one of you, student, parent, grandparent, each one of you uniquely and wonderfully. And God's interacted in your lives in experiential, unique ways. My story of Jesus is different than your story of Jesus. But both of those stories are important. Both of our experiences are going to help other people. And even if our experiences doesn't seem so big or fanciful as our friends, our experience is still important. Peter and John shared their experience, and other people were impacted. And we get to do the same thing. And that's where the challenge comes up, right? It can be hard for us in our world to share how our lives with Jesus are. There's some weird feelings around Christians. There's people who aren't really for that in our schools, in our groups, and sometimes we can feel like it's a weird thing to bring up. But friends, part of our love and grace of God means that we get to share that. It doesn't have to be some like big pedestal moment where you stand up and say, guess what, I love God. But we get to share God in small ways. If someone is struggling, maybe we tell them where you can pray for them. Or maybe that's too weird, and maybe you just say, oh man, I'm sorry, I love you, and I'm sorry to hear that. Maybe sharing Jesus for you looks like just not talking bad about somebody when the group is talking bad about somebody. Maybe it looks like inviting other people into a conversation. God opens up opportunities for us to talk about what God has done in our lives. And it's easy to do that in small group, but it's hard to do that in big groups outside of church. But the habit we're focusing on this week is talking about God in the outside. Connecting our relationship with God with our relationship in the world. Like I said, that's challenging, but we know that like Peter and John, when we begin to do that, that things will change. That people will change. That our seasons of life and rhythms will change. You guys know, if you are at middle school small group, that we have a leader named Lauren. And she's a new leader. She just started coming the last couple of months. And Lauren is incredible at sharing Jesus with others. She doesn't know I'm saying this. She is incredible at sharing Jesus with others. She goes into the city and she talks to friends and she always brings up her love of Jesus. And the stories she's told me have challenged me because I'm not always great at sharing Jesus with others. People know I'm a pastor, they know I love God, but sometimes I don't always cross that barrier to telling them about my experience with Jesus. But Lauren does. And when Lauren takes that step of courage to share Jesus with others, she sees people's lives transformed. And it's incredible. And friends, part of building this relationship with God is leaning into those moments where we feel like God is opening up conversations, opening up moments to share Jesus with others. And so our habit this week, the one we're all going to be working on, is talking about God to others, sharing our experience with God with others. In this way, we not only get to grow in our own story and our own love of God, but we get to share that with other people and we get to help them experience God for maybe the first time. It's a difficult habit, but it's a good one for us to begin to develop, to share our story so that others can experience their own story with God. So what does that look like for us practically, right? We do challenges normally, and the challenges so far have been like reading the Bible and praying. What does it look like for us to practically share a story of Jesus this week? Well, the practical is in the habit. The habit is talking about God with others. And so your challenge is to talk about other, or talk to, not about others, talk to God with others. Talk about God with others. Wow. That other group may just need to be your family to start off with, or your small group leader, or a really close friend, and that's okay. But maybe your other, or your group is going to be your friendship group, or your sports group, or your dance group. Our challenge this week is to think of one, to be open to one opportunity to share God with others. We can do it. I know we can. I'm going to be doing the challenge with you guys. But as we build our habit and our relationship with God, we get to talk about God with others. And that's the habit we're focusing on this week. Can't wait to talk to you guys about it. Talk to somebody about God and learn more about God in that experience. You can do it. Ready, set, go.